We are keeping our eye on the state of education, and tonight some music educators are calling for equity. They say tough COVID restrictions could put a limit on how much students can participate in school music programs.
7 Eyewitness News senior reporter Eileen Buckley explains how some of those same educators feel the state can create a better plan that is music to the ears of everyone.
Music educators and students across the region are working hard to be creative in learning, rehearsing, and performing music and singing virtually. Music classes now have limited classroom instruction, but tough COVID restrictions continue to create challenges.
I'd like to be able to give them the joy that comes with, you know, an audience applauding.
New York State recommends students are separated by 12 feet and cannot perform for an audience. But Dr. David Brown, president of the New York State Music Association and a school superintendent near Syracuse, says we are the only state in the eastern U.S. following that recommendation.
12 feet is a recommendation. 12 feet is not a mandate. It is recommended, but school district superintendents and boards take recommendations very strongly.
Brown has been calling on the governor and state health department to make a change. Educators say they've had enough.
It's infuriating. It's frustrating. It's sad for my students.
Helen Ehaz is a band director at the Westfield Academy in the Westfield Central School District. She says now that high-risk sports are allowed, it's time to lift restrictions for music as well. She even wrote this letter to the governor calling for equity.
There's pictures of basketball players, you know, that are 2 inches away from each other's face with no mask, and yet we have to be 12 feet apart.
James Burritt, a vocal music teacher at Lewiston Porter Central Schools, agrees.
How frustrated are you as a music educator to see the high-risk sports move forward?
It's always been about equity, really. I guess I'm just confused as to why that isn't something that can happen for our musicians as well.
It is a point shared by Kenmore East band director Phil Agulia. He points to this extensive Colorado study that shows the aerosol spread from instruments and recommends 6 feet with special masks.
Put your mouthpiece in there and then it closes when you pull it off.
The state health department says guidance exists for classroom instruction, including music classes. School performances, however, fall under the current safety restriction for public performances, which the governor outlined in his State of the State address and NY Pops-Up's announcement. The health department says they are working to safely reopen additional industries, including the performing arts. Not exactly music to the ears of music students who say they just want to play on a level playing field. In Kenmore, Eileen Buckley, 7 Eyewitness News.